Hi, I'm Dr. Lydia Gray. I'm the staff veterinarian here at SmartPak, and today we're going to talk about one of my favorite topics, body condition scoring. What it is, why you should be doing it, how to do it, and then some additional measurements that could also help. The body condition scoring scale is a numerical-based standardized system of assessing fat cover in a horse. It was developed in the 80s by Don Henneke and his team at Texas A&M University. It ranges from 1 to 9, with 1 being emaciated and 9 being very fat or obese. And each number in the scale roughly corresponds to about 50 pounds. By developing this universal standard of body condition scoring, horse owners and veterinarians, nutritionists, and other healthcare professionals are able to talk apples to apples, or at least be on the same page when it comes to discussing a horse's weight. Because one person's perception of what a thin or skinny horse is different than another person's perception. It's also helpful when tracking a horse that's in a controlled weight loss program. If you're trying to get the horse to go from an 8 to a 7.5 to a 7, when you use those numbers, everyone knows what you're talking about. Everyone knows that too thin isn't good, but too fat isn't good either. A study out of Virginia showed that just over half, 51% to be exact, of the horses they studied came in at 7s, 8s, and 9s, which is overweight or obese. And there are some serious health risks associated with being overweight and obese, such as laminitis, equine metabolic syndrome, bone, joint, and tendon injuries, difficulty cooling off after exercise or during hot weather, and just general reduction in performance levels. Next, let's talk about how to body condition score. There are 6 areas to be assessed when measuring the fat cover on a horse's body. The first is along the neck, then behind the shoulders, along the withers, across the ribs, down the back or the loin, and then the tail head. When evaluating each of these 6 areas, it's important to lay your hands on and feel them, as well as to visualize or look at them, because looks can be deceiving. Henneke's body condition scoring chart has criteria for each of the 6 locations that correspond to the 9 numbers. So you use that to come up with a number for each location, and then you just sort of average them up to come up with a general impression for that particular horse. Now, not every horse read the book, so it's okay to not have a nice, neat, whole number like a 4, 5, or 6, a 4.5, 5.5, 6.5 is just fine. Understand that in some disciplines like racing and some life stages like pregnancy, a lower or higher body condition score is preferred. And some horses have extremes in conformation, like a sway back or high withers. They make giving a number to that part of the body very difficult. It's okay to throw those out and just average up the rest of them. Now that we've covered body condition scoring, which is a subjective way of assessing your horse's condition, let's talk about an objective way, and then you can record both of these in your horse's journal to keep track. The most common objective measurement is horse's weight. And to do this, you'll need a commercially available weight tape. I'd recommend picking one, sticking with it, because it's not the absolute numbers on here that are meaningful, it's more the trend, because you're doing this about every month or so. If you don't have a commercially available weight tape, any flexible measuring tape will do. You just have to take an additional measurement and then plug it into a formula, or plug it into our online horse weight calculator, and it will do the math for you. With both these measurement tools, now you can track your horse's weight and condition and work with your veterinarian and nutritionist to maintain his ideal score.